Welcome to issue 59 of the PlayStation Underground. In this issue, we get a glimpse at the new SCEA.com website and find out what goes into bringing you the coolest new community for gamers on the web. Fans of TV's The King of Queens get to hang out with celebrity gamer Patton Oswalt as he shares his deep, dark fitness confessions. We've also got ringside seats as we go behind the scenes with the developers at Crave Entertainment to find out what goes into making a champion for their new title, UFC Throwdown. Then jump right into the ring with their demo in the vault, along with others like Freakstyle and Stuntman. You got all this, plus cool moves, downloads, and more.
PlayStation Underground, we're dedicated to bringing you a one-of-a-kind, behind-the-scenes look at the hot new games coming out for the PlayStation 2. That's why we knew you'd want to find out how to get the jump on the hottest news. In summer 2002, Sony Computer Entertainment launches their new site created by San Francisco design firm 415. You're not going to believe what they have in store for you.
The way I would describe this site is almost as if it's a journey or a train that's taking you into this big, huge community of information and support for gamers.
So in that sense, it could be very much like a game. It's not a thumb-pressing, mad, kill-your-enemies game, but it hopefully is a great exploratory experience for all the people on it.
While there's tons of content throughout the site, to get the best information, you have to be a member of the PlayStation Underground. But don't worry if you're not. It's free to join.
The biggest area of the site is the PlayStation Underground, and this is going to be really a community for gamers to go to get information on PlayStation games that they can't get anywhere else. We will have cheats, codes, hints, walkthroughs, cool moves for games that really don't exist on any other site. We'll also have a game finder, because with 1,500 titles, sometimes you don't know what game you might want to try next. Well, we'll ask the user different questions about what they might want in a game, and we'll provide them a list of games that might work for them.
So what does it take to build the premier gaming site on the web?
You might think that a process like this would start with us sitting around and brainstorming and figuring out all the great ideas that we can think of. But it turns out, in reality, it's the gamers that come up with the ideas.
We actually talk to gamers and find out what they like or don't like about current things that are being done, where, you know, their kind of interests lie. So we really want to try to get into their head, because they are the people that are going to be using the site.
By telling us about yourself, we can feed you information you want to get and also turn off information that you don't want to get. So I think the coolest part is letting them see we've gone beyond information to interaction.
And we also do a session with the client where we get everybody involved in the project together and everybody just throws out ideas. And this is kind of developing some kind of visual dialogue between us and the client so we know exactly what they're talking about. And then we take this information that we get from our creative discovery, and then we take that back to our studio and start to work together with the other designers to come up with, you know, possible directions that we may take.
I would say that the main difference between this project and a lot of the other projects we do is, simply put, the audience. They have extremely high standards for visuals, and so we can really push the visual envelope, and we can really push the user interface design on this, because these folks are very comfortable in this environment, and that's a luxury for us. We don't always have such a sophisticated audience.
Log on to the all-new www.seea.com to discover all the latest in PlayStation information, from peripherals and hardware to hints, cheats, and walkthroughs, as well as the release dates of upcoming titles. And be sure to keep checking back, because content is going to be constantly updated. Get when you combine boxers, wrestlers, and martial artists, put them in an octagon-shaped ring, and plant that ring in the middle of the craziest town on Earth? You get the Ultimate Fighting Championship. And when you take the Ultimate Fighting Championship to the PlayStation 2, you get a brand new fighting game, UFC Throwdown.
Let's go! UFC is Ultimate Fighting Championship. It's the premier mixed martial arts competition in the world. It was established in 1993 kind of as a spectacle for pay-per-view, pitting like jiu-jitsu experts against pretty much all the other martial arts out there. The Ultimate Fighting Championship is 100% real. All of the fights are, the guys are actually making contact with each other. There's actually blood, there's actually arms being twisted in positions that cause them to tap out.
It's punches, kicks, it's real. Real contact, full contact, minimal gloves, not like boxing where there's a bunch of padding.
To find out more about the Ultimate Fighting Championship, we headed to Las Vegas to check out UFC 36 Worlds Collide at the MGM Grand Hotel.
It's mixed martial arts. It incorporates everything, boxing, kickboxing, wrestling, submissions.
In the beginning of the sport, I think it was more or less people training with their own style, and now everybody's going out and trying to gather up people that know as much about each one of them as they possibly can.
I've trained in all of them, and for me, it's just something that combines them all and makes it more exciting, I think.
UFC is 2 men into the octagon, and the best man leaves.
All the fighters that we talked to in Las Vegas loved UFC Throwdown on the PlayStation 2, not just because of the amazing action, but because of all the ways that you can play the game.
We have several modes in the game. The arcade is very similar to what you would want to play in an arcade, where you just fight after fight after fight just to get into the action, play, have fun. UFC mode is actually a simulation of the actual event, which you would see on a pay-per-view event on television. So you have bracketed systems where you move to win the championship belt.
Another mode is tournament mode. That's the party mode, where up to 8 players, human or computer-controlled players, can go into a game and battle it out in their own UFC tournament and vie for the ultimate control of their own octagon in the living room, basically.
What kind of I'm really happy with the PlayStation 2 version is what we're calling the career mode. I played up as like the build the best mode. And what it does is it lets you spend anywhere from 10 or 15 hours really customizing your character.
In career mode, a player goes in and begins to create their character, chooses the fighting style, chooses how they look, skin tone, color their clothes, and decides to name them, their hometown, everything. And when they complete those, they get extra skill points that they can assign to things like their punch skill, grappling skill. If it's maybe a heavier fighter, he's gonna start out slower, so they can increase their speed. After that is done, they can take them through a training process.
Well, you need to go see like a jiu-jitsu master if you wanna learn jiu-jitsu moves. So you actually go and we take the player through learning the different moves as opposed to just giving it to them. And you have a certain amount of like points that you can apply to different disciplines. So you have to pick early on, you know, am I gonna focus on wrestling, you know, for ground-based fighting and kickboxing for striking? Then I've gotta go and actually meet with those masters, and they'll enter you into like small tournaments where you actually get more points.
The game's artists worked overtime to bring the action from the octagon to life.
Well, the beautiful thing about this game is our character models. We have character models that are 9,000 polys plus, which allows us to put a lot of detail into the characters. You'll be able to see their facial animations and the body. As you move your character's arms, the muscles will flex. You'll see hair from real textures that we created by actually taking photos of the fighters. So when you look at the fighters, you'll see scars, tattoos, anything that the real fighter would have on their body, you'll see in the game.
The shading and movement is extremely smooth. The characters are textured to near perfection because these are the fighters that we were trying to emulate and honor in this game. So they kind of need to be close into the detail, so hopefully the fighters will be happy and not come and make us their own little UFC.
There he is, the knockout, what you believe? With all the work that the UFC Throwdown team has done on the game, we wonder if they had any favorite characters.
Yeah, that's kind of a tough one because I've worked with these guys for about the last 2 years and I met a lot of the fighters, and as I mentioned before, you know, a lot of them have become actually pretty close friends. These guys are totally different in the ring than they are outside of the ring. They're definitely some of the nicest guys you'll ever meet, and could never understand that these guys get in there and hit each other as hard as they can in the octagon. I would have to probably say Chuck Liddell, the Iceman, because the guy's got just the most amazing kicks and punishing kicks that you could ever see in the UFC, and then we've replicated that really closely in the actual game.
The reason I use Tito Ortiz is because he's a well-rounded fighter. He has a lot of standing moves like punches, kicks, and a lot of ground moves, so he can work the ground as well. So if I'm fighting a wrestler, you know, he takes me down, I actually have really strong moves on the ground, and he's very diverse.
I'm hoping some of the fighters will come down and check out the game, and I'm hoping that they're gonna like it and have some fun with us.
Asking me if I know Yu Suzuki. With a DualShock controller in your hand, you only speak in half sentences. For a second, I forget about the game on the screen and worry about if the controller will hold up under this pounding. I've got a front row seat for the fight. I do, because of Suzuki-san. The enemies come fast and furious, and I try to fend them off with my best moves. Then suddenly, I realized all of this, the applause, the adrenaline, the battle royale, has got something to do with a guy named Peter.
I'm buying you beer, you've got to listen. This gentleman invented the genre with a game called Virtua Fighter. That's when we learned about a little thing called a polygon.
No, wait, back up. Let me try again. It all started for me in an arcade 9 years ago.
So in 1993, the Virtua Fighter arcade version was completed. And 8 years later, last year, they finished Virtua Fighter 4, the arcade version. And they completed the PS2 version this March.
That's right. My friend Yu Suzuki, the man who invented the 3D fighting game back in 1993, he's brought his latest game, Virtua Fighter 4, home on the PlayStation 2. Now, I know what you're thinking. We've all been here long enough to know. Virtua Fighter is made by Sega, right? How am I playing it on my PlayStation 2?
This is the launch of Virtua Fighter 4 on Sega for PlayStation 2. And for many of us here, that's still very difficult to say. However, this is, as official PlayStation Magazine described, the best fighting game ever made.
One thing dies, another is born. Games come and go, but the classics remain. That's how I found myself in San Francisco, at Sega's Fight Club, getting a special sneak preview of Virtua Fighter 4, and seeing Suzuki-san, who is to blame for it all.
The PS2 version has a lot of new features that you can't get on the arcade game. The three main ones are the AI system, the training mode, and the character edit system. The first, training mode, allows users to learn as they play, and they have fun while they learn the moves and learn how to play the game. The character edit system in Virtua Fighter 4 has over 400 hidden items in the game. These are like sunglasses, different clothes, different hats, all kinds of different things that you can use to customize your character, and basically make a character all your own. Third is the AI system. A lot of people think that fighting games are only for hardcore gamers, or the controls are too difficult and they can't really learn to play them. But even for people like that, they can use this AI system to train their own AI fighter, and basically cheer them on and watch their character fight for the game.
You could see it all at the Sega Fight Club. People from all over the world, living one day at a time, coming to blow off steam. There was a martial arts demonstration from the U.S. Wing Chun Kung Fu Academy, which is fitting because it was experiencing just such a kung fu demonstration that inspired Suzuki-san to create Virtua Fighter in the first place.
The original reason I decided I wanted to make Virtua Fighter was because I went to China and saw a bunch of martial arts masters and really took an interest in that. And so when I came back to Japan and was describing this to my staff, I needed to be able to show them what sort of moves I was talking about.
I became addicted to his game in the arcades. Now I can play it at home. And I'm not alone. Four tournament winners from around the nation were brought to the Sega Fight Club to show us what they had, and to fight for a Virtua Fighter 4 arcade machine, signed by Suzuki himself.
They flew me out here on Saturday and gave me an amazing hotel to stay out, and cash to go get in trouble with, and today just won an arcade machine from Sega.
All night long we fought, shaking off our normalness, becoming more real, more alive. Now I'm not sure where the line is between the game and reality, where the fighting ends. The controller is in my hands, the PlayStation 2 is always on, and I think it's all because of Yu Suzuki. I should know. I know the man and his games.
This is where I make money to buy drugs.
So, I play this character named Spence on the show King of Queens, and he's like one of the wacky sidekick guys.
That's our director, and I don't want to bother them. Let's watch them work for a second.
So if you don't fight the bucket will be your friend. Do you understand?
Okay. Yeah, so then that's basically what we have.
This is my first PlayStation 2. If any of my friends are watching this, I'm sorry I haven't called, but it's because I've been in here playing PlayStation and eating Cheetos.
Yeah.
My friends all have them when I go over to their houses, and I'll spend hours, man. And I'm at their house. Like, I'm supposed to be visiting and being social, and I'm just sitting there like an idiot playing Grand Theft Auto 3. You know, I first started getting into them playing them on my computer when I was writing, which was a bad, really bad idea. So now in my mind I'm thinking, okay, I'll just get a separate system, put it on my TV, and I'll parcel it out. Like, I'll play it for now and then go, okay, I gotta get work done, and then I'll do 5 minutes of work and then another hour playing the video game. Because I'm such an idiot. Sorry.
8 a.m. tomorrow?
No. Perfect.
You got the day off.
This time, make sure that they Simonize, okay?
Got it.
Hey, fatty, stop fooling yourself. Get a PS2, all right? You're not going to excel at sports, and women don't like you. Get it? It'll be your only friend. I've made the switch. Why don't you? The world will be a better place. People like us shouldn't be outside, because we just get hurt. That'd be my ad. I'm serious, man. Why the hell are people going outside? We went mountain biking today. Really? I've got that on CD-ROM. I already did that. And I ate cereal while I did it, genius. So why don't you and Grizzly Adams go climb a mountain or something and wrestle an eagle? I'm gonna save the universe from demon aliens. Yeah, shoot, get a shot of the treadmill that I don't use. Get a shot of the treadmill. Ha ha, I don't use that. I just have it there to impress the chicks. And I hang my nunchucks from it. I hang my nunchucks off my treadmill. How symbolic is that? How pathetic. Whatever.
Dragon's Lair, a fantasy adventure where you become a valiant knight on a quest to rescue the fair princess from the clutches of an evil dragon. You control the actions of a daring adventurer finding his way through the castle of a dark wizard who has enchanted it with treacherous monsters and obstacles. In the mysterious caverns below the castle, your odyssey continues against the awesome forces that oppose your efforts to reach the dragon's lair. Lead on, adventurer. Your quest awaits.
Rated E for everyone.
Sip the juice, I got enough to go around, and the thought takes place uptown. I grew up on a sidewalk while on street talk, and then taught to hawk New York. I go to Queens for Queens to get the food from Brooklyn. Make money in Manhattan and never been took it. Go uptown to the Bronx and boogie down, get strong on the island, recoup and lay around. Time to build my juice back up, pop stack up, suckers get smacked up. Don't doubt the clout, you know what I'm about. Knock, off, knock, out, shaking them up, waking them up, breaking them up, breaking them up. Standing on shaky ground, too close to the edge. Let's see if I know the ledge. Corners trifling, cause shorty's here. I get cocked, D, living for. Here's a sip for the crew that's deceased. If I get revenge, then it. Somebody got a self, I just might spare one and give a brother a fair one. Stay alerted on fees, and I do work with these like Hercules. Switch to southpaw, split your right jaw, cause I don't like y'all, I'm hype when night fall. Smooth, but I move like an army. Pull a group down, face brothers try to bomb me. Putting brothers to rest like Elliot Ness, cause I don't like stress. Streets ain't a place for innocent bystanders to stand. Nothing's gonna stop the plan. I'll chill like Pacino, like De Niro, Black Gambino, die like a hero. Living on shaky ground, too close to the edge. Let's see if I know the ledge.
Your mommy.
Thank you. Thank you.